What's up, guys? Hope that y'all had a fantastic weekend. I appreciate all the love in this new group that we started on Facebook, and thank all of you guys for helping us grow this as a relevant community for active and aspiring wedding photographers looking for advice in business and technique. You guys are definitely awesome. So again, thank you. As a reminder, we are hosting a giveaway in the LWP group that ends on Wednesday. The prize is the full set of the MAP Master Preset Collection, okay? These are the same presets that we use in our business to achieve the looks that you guys see in our finalized images. We spent over 2 years tweaking and developing this system, and in my obviously biased opinion, they are the best presets available today on the market. They'll also help you guys with things like same-day slideshows, editing quickly, and an efficient workflow. To enter, all you guys have to do is add 10 of your friends to the LWP group and comment on our giveaway post just by saying done, okay? Once you guys do that, we'll assign you a random number. We'll be picking three people on Wednesday to win a set of our presets. Now, for those of you guys who are just checking out this video for the first time or maybe just entered our group, a few days back I posted a question on my personal Facebook timeline. I asked you guys what the biggest challenges that you guys were facing in your wedding photography business. A lot of you guys answered, and I was actually surprised at how many responses we got. Seems like there's a lot of challenges that we're facing as wedding photographers. But keep in mind, guys, no business is without challenges, right? And the most successful businesses will usually face the highest and the most difficult challenges compared to those who are just getting started, although it might not seem that way for some of you guys who are just starting out your business. For those of you guys who don't know me, I own two wedding photography businesses right now. I own Michael Anthony Photography, which is our main brand, the one that Jennifer and I started back in 2012. And then we own Studio 23, which we started in 2015. It's a team of talented associate photographers, all of them who are members of this LWP group. Together, we split about 100 weddings per year right down the middle. So you can imagine, then dealing with 100 brides per year, what type of challenges that we're gonna face month in and month out. It actually makes my head hurt if I just think about it. It's Monday morning, so I won't depress myself too much, right? I would say that most of the challenges that you guys are facing, our business has probably dealt with in one way or another, or is continuing to deal with. Some of them are things that we have to always adapt and innovate to come up with solutions for. Now, before I start, guys, I promise I'm gonna get into marketing. That was definitely the most popular challenge that you guys have, marketing and advertising. But let me do that at the end because it's gonna take the most time out of this video, right? So let's go ahead and get started. First challenge from Mike Purdy, okay? Time management and efficient workflow, okay? Great, great question, Mike. I gotta be honest, this was a huge, huge headache for us, brother. Our studio went from 27 weddings in 2013 to 45 in 2014, to 70 in 2015, to 100 in 2016. This year we have 100 weddings booked already. With that type of growth, you can imagine how many challenges and how many files and how many problems with order fulfillment that we had, right? Now, I wrote an article in Shutter Magazine back in November on workflow, okay? You can check that out, and I recommend that you do because we've ironed that process out. But most importantly, a business owner always needs to have good time management, right? I found that if I'm spending time in my business doing tasks related to production, where most of us spend too much time, it hurts my business massively, right? The only solution is to get help, right? Now, you can get help from one of two ways. You can outsource or you guys can hire, right? Hiring is expensive, and therefore, you would need to outsource everything that you can before you think about hiring an employee. That's my recommendation to you, right? For photographers specifically, you need to outsource editing. Okay, we use Evolve Edits to handle the color correction on our images. We've been doing that since, I think, 2012. We're not sponsored by them. I don't get anything for telling you guys to use them, but trust me, okay, my business would never, ever have grown to where it is today if we never signed up for their Premiere program. It's a big step, but I definitely recommend doing it. It's a touchy subject for photographers. I definitely know that, too. They don't want to give up control of their images, right? It's our art, okay? But would the founders of Nike have ever grown the company to over $20 billion if they were still making the shoes in a basement, right? Of course not, okay? You guys have to learn to let go of some things. Are the color-corrected images that we get back from our editors perfect? No, of course not, but they're color-corrected. We're not telling our clients that we have the best digital negatives out there on the market. We're telling them that we're art-focused and we show them the high-quality products that we make in the studio, right? During their sales sessions. If you guys brand yourself as art-focused, it's gonna save you guys a ton of time in production. It's gonna help you guys make a lot more money as well, too. Now, not necessarily for Mike, but this question comes up a lot, and it's good to address it for everybody. If you guys are currently selling digital negatives or edited files, right, that becomes your product. That becomes the final deliverable that you give to your client. You need to make sure that your final product is perfect, right? But it's not feasible to make 100 or 1,000 images perfect. It's gonna take you a lot longer to edit 100 images from a portrait session than it would to edit 10 images perfectly that they choose for print, okay? You're gonna suffer on delivery times if you guys are out there trying to edit every image to perfection. Work smarter, not harder, right? I promise, getting into a art-focused mentality, you're gonna save yourself a lot of time and money. Next challenge from Marilyn Rossiter, and I'm sorry if I butcher your names, guys. Everybody is a photographer, right? They charge almost nothing. That is totally true, okay? But Marilyn, you are not a photographer, okay? You're an entrepreneur who's created a business taking photos that not only gives your clients an incredible imagery, right? But you're also creating heirloom products that will last them generations, right? In addition to that, you're giving them an experience that they will never, ever forget. You have to keep that in mind when you are thinking about this subject. Your competitors are charging nothing because they have not figured out how much time it takes to give their clients an incredible experience. Shoot and burn photographers always leave the market. I'm gonna tell you guys this now. I've seen it over and over again in just 5 years in business. Their lifespan's about 18 months. After that, they're gone, they're back to their day jobs, or they change their business model. It happens to everybody. You know, if you guys are tempted to lower your prices to compete, just stop. You can't compete in a race to the bottom. If you guys do, you're gonna go out of business. It's just a matter of time, right? Studio 23, our budget brand, right, has an average sale of over double the average cost of wedding photography in Los Angeles, all right? That's our budget brand, guys. We would never, ever get that if we were competing with like George Street Photography or The Pros or, you know, Jessica's wedding photos that just popped up down the street. Instead, we hired the best talent. We went through over 300 applications last fall when we moved to contractors instead of employees. We narrowed that down to 5 shooters, okay? And we spared no expense with our clients either. We offer them the best albums possible. Okay, this is all part of that experience that we're giving them. And you have to keep that in mind in your own business. I hope that helps. Just remember, guys, you're selling an experience. You're not just selling pictures, okay? Next challenge from Eric P, because I couldn't pronounce your last name, sorry. I'm paraphrasing your question here, okay? I think you said, I don't know how to create a portfolio for weddings or engagements or how you get started in your business, right? Dude, I gotta tell you, this is the most fun that you're gonna have with any other challenge that you're gonna face in your business, okay? The answer's simple, and it's 2 parts, all right? First, you're gonna need to second shoot weddings. You're gonna need to make sure that you have enough experience to handle them on your own. That goes without saying, okay? You need to study weddings. You need to learn how to anticipate moments. You need to learn how to handle any lighting situation that you're gonna find yourself in and be able to adapt to different situations because things change all the time, right? Once you have all of that down, and I mean, you really, really understand that, you feel confident with everything, then I would recommend that you set up shoots to create images for your portfolio, because many times if you're second shooting, they're not gonna let you use those images in your portfolio. But here, you're gonna be able to connect with local dress shops, you're gonna be able to connect with tuck shops, you're gonna wanna hire models or find models, and you're gonna need to put together concepts. I mean, it's fun, all right? There's gonna be an expense involved in this, but it's minimal, right? It's pretty minimal setting up shoots. This is the first impression, your portfolio, that clients are gonna have of you. So make sure that you guys make it worth it when you are setting up these portfolio shoots, right? Now, from all these shoots, you're gonna wanna make images for every single vendor that helped you set them up. Okay, this will help you get in the door with them to start that relationship. Don't just bring them a flash drive. They're gonna throw that in the drawer and they're just gonna forget about it, okay? I promise you, all right? Instead, bring them a print with your logo on it, ready to hang, okay? Offer them to help hang it in their office. They might turn you down, they might not, but if they hang it for you, that's advertising in their business. This way you cover 3 things. You're covering your experience, your portfolio, and you're beginning to start relationship marketing, okay? Next question from David Alonzo and my hometown friend, Scott Madrigal, okay? Finding your style, all right? That's a big question. Guys, don't sweat this at all, right? Your style of photography will largely be based on you, okay? Where you guys grew up, the experiences that you had, your background, where you live, right? There's science behind this, but you don't need to know all of that, okay? All you need to know is that your style will come to you naturally over time. But if you wanna get to it faster, I recommend looking for inspiration, okay? I currently look to cinema for inspiration in my own work. Early on, I also looked at other photographers. That's a great source of inspiration if you find people that you know, you love their work. from there, you want to learn technique, right? You want to learn how to manipulate light. You want to learn how to anticipate moments. You want to learn how to tell stories through a series of images. Okay, once you guys do all of that, then you'll have a well-rounded skill set to be able to create images that, you know, inspire you. Over time, you guys are going to see your style develop. Okay, understand that your style of photography will change over and over and over again. My style of photography has changed massively over the last 3 to 5 years, and a lot even over the last year. Some of that is because of the trends in our industry, and some of that is due to the buying habits of my clients. In-person sales is a great way to refine your style, okay? I tell this to a lot of people who ask me, but when people buy your images, that means what you're doing is working. And when they're not buying it, that means you need to change some things, right? Here's an example of that. We had a photographer who used to work for Studio 23, okay? He would do these stoic or these serious poses for our clients. They hated it. They would never buy those pictures, all right? When I would do my same version of James Bond or Vanity Fair, right? The clients would buy those photos, and I didn't understand what it was. The differences in the images were really, really subtle, but really what it had to do with was the instruction I gave the clients at the time of capture, right? By using certain verbiage with them, refining their expression, paying attention to little details like hand placement, light quality, right? It made a big difference in the final product. My employee was just looking at them and telling them, hey, look serious, right? When we walk them through the process, we help them feel more confident doing a pose that can make them feel nerdy or dorky. That confidence that they had translated into sales, even though there were just small differences in the images, okay? That experience led me to pay closer attention to those same details on images other than our fashion poses, right? So even like when we're just doing a traditional portrait, paying attention to little things, it'll make a difference and it'll help you refine your style. Next question, our next challenge from Ramona, okay? The need for constant communication, social media, phone, etc. Okay? Truthfully, you always have to be on for this generation. Definitely challenging. I agree with you 100%. We're just one person, most of us in our business, right? But you already know the answer, okay? You always have to be on. We've had upset clients when we didn't respond at 9 a.m. to an email sent at 11 p.m. the night before. All right. Some people need to be hammered a little bit when they act like children, right? Clients sometimes. However, you can ask Jen or Courtney. I'm always on top of my team for response time. It has to be swift, especially for new leads. It has to be right away because they're inquiring with a lot of other photographers, right? That being said, I did opt for an 800 number so my clients aren't calling my cell phone 24/7, okay? Your response time is directly related to the amount of inquiries that respond back to you. Just keep that in mind. Really, really important to make sure that you're responding in a timely manner, okay? Next challenge from Marcy Alfred. Again, sorry about your name, right? Booking the client. We've had inquiries, but need help in turning them into a yes client, okay? In addition to response time, everything that you guys say in your initial email has a lot to do with if you're gonna hear back from your clients. It really does. I mean, you have to be careful. Every word matters. We've refined every single word in our inquiry process to get the best rate of response that we possibly can, and we always do make changes. We sell our inquiry responses along with the rest of our follow-up and our email templates in our online store. But for those of you guys who prefer to write your own, there are a few key points that you have to hit when you are responding to an initial inquiry, right? First of all, ask questions. Brides love talking about their wedding. Ask them some questions about their venue. Ask them some questions about their wedding colors, why they choose their date, how do they meet, all of those things in the initial email. They will respond to that. Keep the email relatively short. Millennials don't have time to read a novel. I'm a millennial, and if my staff sends me a message that is longer than 3 lines, I just skip it and ask them to paraphrase it and send it again, right? Nobody's got time for that, sorry. Brag a little bit, but not a lot, okay? Let them know that you're experienced. Give them something that they can't find online about you, right? But don't list off a list of your accolades and awards if they're longer than a sentence or two. That just gets boring, right? It sounds pretentious. Millennials hate that. And right now you're marketing to millennials. Most importantly, don't give pricing in your initial email, okay? This is the most important part about getting more responses. Pre-qualify your clients with a starting price, but for heaven's sake, stop sending the entire price list to them. When you do that, they have nothing to judge you by except for your starting price, okay? If you are making money in photography, that starting price has to be at least in line with the average price of a wedding in your market. But in reality, if you want to have a profitable business, your clients are going to have to spend much higher than the average, or you're going to end up going out of business. It's just a fact of life now. There is a lot of competition in our business. For those of you guys who interrupt me here and you say, well, Michael, you know, they have my images to judge me by. Just please understand that clients don't know the difference between good photography and great photography. They really don't, okay? They need you guys to point out your greatness to them subtly during the consultation when they're meeting with you guys, okay? Next challenge, CJ Bryant, okay? Getting clients to do day after sessions or bridal sessions. This is a really, really good topic. Great question, by the way, CJ. Bridal sessions or post-wedding sessions allow you guys to take more time to create amazing portraits for your brides and grooms on, you know, in times when you don't have the time or, you know, capacity to do it on the actual wedding day. Our first year that we were offering bridal sessions in all of our collections, we only had two clients take us up on the offer. Remember, they were included. People still weren't booking them. We found out that in order to get more than to take you up on it, you have to sell them on the idea of the bridal session from the initial consultation, right? Show them bridal session images. We show them some trash address images that were obviously not shot on the wedding day. Nobody's getting in the water, you know, at the beach on their wedding day, right? So we show them that on the during their initial consultation. We get them excited about it. We talk to them about Inception rentals. We talk to them about the fashion dresses. We let them know that they don't have to wear their own wedding dress either. That could be a point of contention for a lot of people from actually doing the bridal session. Lastly, get the day after session scheduled on the calendar ahead of time. If you're waiting for them to call you to schedule it, you're never gonna hear back from them. You gotta be proactive here and you'll see those numbers go up. Believe me, bridal sessions are very profitable. You definitely wanna make sure you're scheduling those. Sarah Barkley, lead management. You need help with lead management, right? 17 hats, Tave, another CRM. That's the most important thing you have to do, okay? This is gonna help you with all aspects of your businesses, not just lead management, workflow, deliverables, keeping you organized. You have to automate a lead system, and follow-up emails will be automatically sent out. We have ours in our store. If you guys are interested in our email templates at www.learnweddingphotography.com, okay, you definitely want to make sure that you're staying organized. That's the biggest problem people have with lead management. Okay, guys, let's get into the biggest challenge for all of you guys, marketing and advertising, right? A lot of you guys asked about this, and most people who ask this question have no idea where to start, right? Some are looking for the silver bullet in marketing, and they think that one idea is gonna help them bring them new business, right? I'm gonna break your heart here. I'm gonna tell you guys that silver bullet for marketing doesn't exist at all. It's not there, okay? It has to be all-encompassing. Everything you do in marketing has to be 360, right? Think about it like this, okay? If a bride that lives an hour away from you ask her friend to recommend a wedding photographer, or even goes online to find a wedding photographer, are they gonna see your name in the first couple of minutes of searching? Okay, that's the key that's the marker that you have to hit, right? If they're not, how do you expect them to even consider you as a wedding photographer? Okay, especially with all the competition we have nowadays. There have been studies done that show that people have to see your name from at least five different sources before they consider you an expert in your subject, okay? People are spending thousands of dollars precisely for expertise in the subject of wedding photography, right? So in order for them to hire you, they need to first consider you as an expert, and they need to see your name over and over and over again before they actually do that, okay? Lastly, marketing has to be persistent, and I mean persistent, okay? Especially if you guys are brand new. If you walk into a venue one day and you introduce yourself, next week the catering manager that you just introduced yourself is gonna have no idea who you are, unless they're seeing your name five different times, right? It works for them as well too. The best clients who come to us can't remember where they first heard about us, right? But they keep telling us that our name popped up everywhere. That is exactly what we want to hear during a consultation. When we hear that, it's 100% booking rate, right? In my market, I am very persistent and I'm very competitive too, right? If one of my local competitors puts up a print at a venue, I'm gonna bring a bigger print to the venue. And if I'm friendly with the catering manager, I'm gonna ask them to put that bigger print where the smaller print was if the other vendor chopped off. Maybe it's ruthless, but business is a sport. I intend to win. I'm competitive, like I said before, right? You guys gotta be the same way. Just keep that in mind. Chances are what you guys are doing right now, it probably is working, right? But you probably just aren't doing enough of it. So let's talk about a couple marketing sources, and I just wanna talk to you guys from experience to show you guys how we got to 100 weddings a year in less than four seasons. Keep in mind that we're charging 2 to 5 times the average price of a wedding photographer in LA, all right? And that's for both brands. Word of mouth, guys. This is the largest marketing source, and it should be your first point of contact that your clients have with you, your first priority in the marketing funnel. Word of mouth isn't the same necessarily as referrals, right? In my opinion, word of mouth means a firsthand experience of an account that somebody had with you guys, right? I'm sorry, a firsthand account of an experience somebody had with you guys. Now, word of mouth can be good, and it should be, but it can also be bad. That means that every single interaction that somebody has with you has to be held in a positive light. Every last experience that a client has with you or leaves your studio with will be the most important experience that they actually have in the entire process. You can't leave them let down. Okay, that's important, really important, trust me. Our clients who have had us throughout the entire process love us, right? But we also love them and we treat them like gold. We spoil them every step of the way in the wedding process, okay? Our clients get no less than 3 thank you notes from us from the day they book to after the e-session to one after the wedding as well too. They'll get unexpected gifts in the mail. We send them like Starbucks cards. We send them stuff like that. It changes every couple of months. We also give them a slew of emails of planning advice, right? On the wedding day, our timelines are organized to the very minute, and I do everything I can to make sure that we're sticking to them the entire process. That leaves the client with a good experience, like you're a professional, you're taking care of that timeline, right? You guys saw the same day slideshow that we did in the group. I posted that the other day, right? This is designed to create an experience for them. It's not designed to advertise your services. Forget about that. You don't want to advertise, you're creating a good experience. After the slideshow, every time we have family and friends coming up to us telling us how awesome of a job that we did, right? This is the best marketing that you guys will ever have. Photographers in your area aren't doing this stuff right now, I promise you, right? It's a gamble because there's a ton of things that can go wrong during a same-day slideshow. You don't want to look stupid because your audio or video is not working, right? But you have to take the risk in order to get the reward. I found that over and over and over again in business. Our deliverables are tracked through our CRM system. We're making sure that we're hitting our deadlines and that we're finished with portrait sessions, editing them in 7 days for clients to come in. Weddings are done in 10 days, right? During the engagement session, Jennifer's helping them pick out clothes. She's going back and forth with them through email. Some clients she's even offered to go shopping with too. To top it off, our response times are typically less than 24 hours, at least when things are running smoothly and I'm not traveling, right? But when we are traveling, I do let clients know that I'm traveling and we'll get back to them soon, okay? Our clients always have a dedicated point of contact, okay? Courtney makes sure that all their concerns are addressed immediately. Believe me, even when I see stupid emails come through that don't deserve a response, she makes sure to answer them, even if I tell her to delete them. It's important. You have to have somebody like that taking care of your clients. When we mess up and we miss a deadline, okay, we will lose money to make sure we make up that experience to the client. I don't care. The experience is more important than the $20, $30 it costs for a print, right? Can you guys look at all your processes right now? Can you guys say that you guys are hitting those marks? Maybe, maybe not, right? But don't be alarmed if you're not, because this has taken us several years to figure out. We've made a lot of mistakes, right? If I had to describe anything as our silver bullet in marketing, this would be it, okay? But it takes time and patience before that reputation is gonna sink in within your community. So don't give up, keep doing what you're doing, right? SEO and online ads. SEO and online ads all have their place, right? They'll serve as maybe the second, third, fourth points of contact with your clients before they inquire with you, or at least before they consider you an expert. We've used Facebook ads in the past. They're not that effective anymore. They used to be really good, not so much anymore. Nonetheless, we're still diligent about blogging all of our MA photo weddings. We post to social media 20 to 30 times per week. That's my goal. Sometimes we don't hit those numbers, especially again when I'm traveling or we're out of town, but that's the number that I aspire for every single week. And we try to pre-organize our social media posts via Hootsuite on Sunday. We focus on Facebook and Instagram mainly for our social media, right? But I found Instagram to be much more photographer friendly. You guys are gonna see a lot of photographers following you on Instagram. That's okay. But there are still brides that will see you on Instagram. At least they'll check you out, all right? Review websites, really, really important. Yes, Yelp, WeddingWire, Google, The Knot. You know, whether you guys like it or not, clients are checking out your reviews online. I promise you they are, all of them are, okay? You need to make sure that you have a good online presence, okay? Here's a tip for you guys to help build your online reputation, all right? Don't just ask clients for reviews. Offer to exchange reviews with vendors that you truly thought did a good job, okay? And call yourself a vendor. They can call themselves a vendor. There's nothing that you're hiding here, right? Don't do this just to get reviews, because anyone that you guys recommend to your clients is a reflection on you, right? Instead, save that, you know, for vendors that you actually would recommend, and it'll help you kick off a relationship with them as well too, okay? Online directories like, you know, WeddingWire and The Knot. These are not useless. A lot of people say that they are, but they're not useless like all photographers will tell you if you post in an online forum. They're part of an overall marketing strategy and they should help drive traffic to your business, right? The highest, you wanna order the highest visibility that you can afford, okay? So that means higher up the page if you can, right? Don't just sign up for these services though until you have everything else in place. You wanna make sure that this is one of the last things that you sign up, because they will have the lowest return. Referrals and relationship marketing, all right? This is gonna be the second most important source of business, and it's kind of tied to word of mouth directly, right? What many people don't understand about relationship marketing is that relationships need to be built over time. I made this mistake early on. I tried too hard to network with vendors that were just not open to reciprocating referrals. They had their network and I wasn't gonna get into it, right? Instead, I started focusing on developing relationships that I already had with people who were maybe up and coming in the business, right? Meaning, when I met a catering manager at a wedding, or I work with a wedding planner, right? I started slowly developing those relationships with nothing expected in return. You have to keep that in mind. I never asked a vendor to refer me. Never done it, okay? A true relationship shouldn't be built on what someone can do for you, right? You wouldn't treat a friend like that, right? Don't you guys all have a friend, for instance, who will call you only when they want something? You guys know it, right? Don't be that friend with your vendors. People see through that BS. They do. They just do. You know, if somebody wants something from you, hopefully it's genuine, right? Hopefully you guys have a relationship, but once you do, they'll be more open to referring you naturally. When you guys are starting a relationship with a vendor, we recommend sending them maybe like an automated template after the wedding, right? We have a template that we send out to all of our vendors after the wedding that'll allow them to pre-register for the client's gallery. As soon as they're available, it'll send them another email to invite them to the gallery, right? Now, if there's somebody that I specifically want to work with, we have a template that we'll send out asking for a meeting. This template works 90% of times. You're offering to give the vendor something, pictures, right? Once you guys get the meeting, you need to bring them a frame print or a canvas, something to help kick off that relationship. Don't just bring them a flash drive, like I said earlier, right? They're gonna take that flash drive, throw it in a drawer, and as soon as you guys leave, they are gonna forget about you, right? Put something in their showroom so that their clients can see it when they walk in and they sit down for a consultation. If they're not letting you do this at first, guys, just keep working the relationship. Eventually, they will come around. I promise you that, all right? Also, you got to give a little bit to get a little bit, right? You guys are high on the bride's shopping list. Throw referrals down the chain if you can to vendors, you know, like makeup artists, like tuxedo places. They may not have a chance to refer you back because of their position in the usual purchasing line, but it will help you guys get word of mouth referrals. It's going to help that overall, you know, perception of your brand, right? Throw some referrals up the chain when you guys get an opportunity to wedding planners, to venues, okay? Become a connector. You guys will see your referrals increase tremendously. It will take time. I'm not going to lie to you. This is something that might take 8-9 months before you start seeing results, but it will work, I promise. Email marketing. Email marketing works well to reconnect with your audience, okay? Many brides will inquire with you, but they need that extra push to pull the trigger. We use email marketing to market to past clients, stay in front of new brides that have not yet made a decision to book yet. All of your other marketing sources are designed to get your leads in the door, and email marketing is that one source that is designed to convert them into actual paying clients and even reconvert old clients into new paying clients. You guys gotta make sure that you're using a CRM to gather all of your email addresses in one place, and then use something like MailChimp. There's a lot of them. Just look up email marketing apps, but we use MailChimp to send out our emails, right? Okay, guys, I hope that this helped with some of the challenges that you guys are facing. Speaking of challenges, I'm actually going to challenge you guys weekly to produce images related to a specific topic. We'll be posting what that topic is in the group. It's going to be a great way for you guys to share your latest work with the community so you guys can actually help inspire others and also challenge yourself to think a little bit differently outside of your own box, right? In your own style of photography. Now, we're going to be posting this video on our website for future viewing at www.learnweddingphotography.com so you guys can go back and refer to any of this in the future if you guys want to, right? Just a reminder, our long-awaited Lightroom preset system is available on our website as well. So if you guys want that, you guys can check that out as well at www.learnweddingphotography.com/presets. Thank you guys again. I appreciate everything that you guys are doing, and we'll catch you next time with our next video.